remember those times growing up? Christmas, Easter, family gatherings, a shared meal, watching your parents chatting and laughing and joining in. You took it all in, sharing all of this through language. I'm lucky to be like you. I'm one of only 3% of deaf kids who grew up with deaf parents, and I too shared your experience of complete access to those conversations around me. 97% of deaf kids will be born to people like you. We call you hearing. Those kids' experiences are different. Less than 1 in 4 hearing parents learn to sign to give their children access to the world around them. The majority of deaf kids are expected to change who they are, to learn to speak and listen, often with limited success, to become so-called normal. But why am I telling you this? Let me tell you about the research on mental health in deaf people. We know about the high rates of depression, anxiety, and suicidality experienced by deaf adults, and that number is growing faster than in the hearing population. Could it be that those childhood experiences of language deprivation play a part? That's what I wanted to find out. My position in this research is unique. I am a deaf researcher working within my community. Now look at this slide. The child here in the green t-shirt was born deaf, with full access to communication via sign language from birth. The child in the white shirt was also born deaf, but did not acquire sign language until later at 6 or 7 years old. Would their mental health outcomes in adulthood be the same or different? To answer this important question, I've designed 3 studies. The first study, which I've just started, involves in-depth interviews with up to 15 deaf adults with experience of mental ill health. The second study is a national survey of over 300 deaf people to explore possible connections between language access at home and mental health in adulthood. In the third study, I will develop a series of statements to be ranked by deaf people on their priorities for service provision in this area. Through this work, I will generate deaf-centred recommendations for changes to mental health systems to decrease deaf mental health in the future. I want to see that the 97% of deaf children experience the same communication and belonging as I did, including at Christmas.